I'm Nux.
That's why with confidence this week,
listen,
y'all. Well, you better know
it
who
gets
he
better
is.
Every time.
Yeah,
you better know.
You better know it. And also, we have our dopest guest. One of our dopest guests of the night, y'all. Business owner of the block, Miss
Maya Harris.
I almost like,
yes. How you doing?
I'll be in a moment. Give him some, sis.
Oh, listen, the career cheerleader, Kara Presley, always here. Talking streets. Yes.
You already know. And we the streets insiders, y'all. Yes. And here to show off the dopest go-getters in the DMV area, okay? So tonight we're showing off Miss Maya Harris. Mm-hmm. She is awesome and amazing. Like I stated before, she's our business owner of the block because she got the block jumping.
That's what they say.
Yeah, that's what they say. So tonight I want you to tell the people who you are and what it is you do. We're here to show you all.
Absolutely.
So talk to them. It's a talking street.
Look, I'm proud of you because last time I
y'all
came to see
do
you.
Y'all always do that to me.
Come on.
Oh my God.
Last time I came to see you, we were in a different studio.
Come on.
The table fell.
Listen! Come on, bro! Okay?
The table fell. We kept it going, though.
Yeah.
Well, I'm proud of what you're doing.
True.
So I'm excited to be here.
Oh,
so,
Maya, thank
absolutely,
you.
Absolutely. So my name is Maya Harris. Thank you guys, career coach, cheerleader, everything you made it.
I know.
Mr. Nuts, you're very nice to see you too, sir.
It is nuts.
Just nuts.
The cake.
Yeah.
Got you. Like good to know. Good to know.
Right.
Pronunciation
is
important.
We got it.
Pronunciation is important. Yes, that's right. But I am the founder and CEO of WOOM, which is the acronym for Women-Owned Minority Businesses.
Okay.
And we're a business incubator for women of color who are entrepreneurs. And we help them start, grow, and sustain their businesses.
Okay.
So that's where I met you.
Yeah.
Okay. You were like at one of my first events.
I was a part of She.
That's right.
Yes, so you know, way back.
Way back to the coffee shop.
Come on.
Listen. Color create businesses, well, ventures, I want to say, ventures that are sustainable.
Right.
And that's just been a passion of mine for the past 7 years or so. And so this is, we have birthed WOOM to bring it here to Richmond, and it's already starting to grow and spread to different areas.
Yeah, pun intended.
Absolutely.
Now, I love it. What about women is most dear to you? Of course, aside the fact that you are
besides the fact that I'm a woman, right? Yes.
What is near and dear? Right. What's near and dear to you about women that made you say, "Hey, I want to be a part of this organization that cultivates women."
Absolutely. Right. Well, as a business owner, I'm a single mom. Number one, right?
Oh, okay.
And I'm a single mom of two amazing young men. Mm. And as a single mom, single moms always have an extra hustle.
Right. Like
you have your full-time job, your second full-time job, your part-time job, your spare time job, right?
That one.
And the lifelong job. Right.
Yeah.
Right. And not to slight our brothers at all, but I just have a passion for helping women, you know, come into their own.
Right.
And we're so busy always taking care of everybody else. We tend to put our dreams on the back burner.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And it's my goal to help women recognize that dream that they've put away is actually the thing that will catapult them to the next level.
Come on, doula.
I
like it. Help them give birth.
That's a new hashtag.
Yes, I love it.
And so I tell my women all the time. I said, you know, I like statistics. I'm a former teacher, which you know, right? And Forbes magazine put out an article in 2012 that said African American women start businesses 3 times more than any other subgroup.
That's right.
Listen.
So we're killing the game, right?
Yeah.
Listen.
Problem is, we are earning on average $27,000 a year versus our white sisters who earn an average of $170,000 a year.
Big problem. Big
huge problem. And
that's why we have 6 side hustles.
Well, that's part of the problem.
Hair, watching
that's,
kids.
That's part of the problem.
Mm. Yeah.
Because we get excited, we are passionate, we got the education, we have the motivation.
Right.
But we don't have the training.
Right.
Right.
We don't have the collaborative spirit that right. we need. Mm-hmm. And we're afraid that somebody's gonna steal our idea.
That's right.
I can't tell nobody because you're gonna take my stuff. Yeah, right. You know, I'm just flying solo right now. But that's what
collaboration. That's why
I'm
broke.
Collaboration is important.
I'm a firm believer that you can get far by yourself.
Right.
I mean, you can get fast. You can get fast by yourself, but you get far with a team. You know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
I'm a firm believer.
Yeah. Collaboration over competition.
Yeah. Absolutely. Everybody can eat.
Right.
McDonald's can put up a store next to Burger King, right. and everybody's fine,
everybody
then
sell
you better come right. everywhere you see right. a Bass Auto, you see right. an AutoZone.
Right. Across the street.
Home
okay.
Depot's always across the street from Lowe's.
Right.
Target's always near Walmart.
But we all go to those different places for their individual little quality.
Exactly. Right.
McDonald's
exactly.
is the fries. Do you. What's your you?
Exactly.
Your it.
That's right.
Exactly. I love it.
So it's a matter of teaching this. We know what our passions are, but it's a matter of giving them the background that they need in order to do what they have to do.
Resource. Come through resources.
The resources, the planning, the how do you do a business plan? You know,
and I want to say
things
because you were a teacher,
yes.
you know, there's nothing wrong with sharing information. I don't know why we're trying to hold on to stuff and just keep it
that's
to
cultural.
Ourselves.
Yeah. That's a cultural problem.
Right.
You know, because as African Americans, so many things are always taken away from us.
Right.
And so when we get something that we're passionate about, that we love, we want to hold on to
it
for fear of it being taken away. But that's actually been purposely, you know, programmed into us because they know that that's what's going to help us grow.
So when are we going to break the cycle?
We have to break the cycle.
Right. But you know what? Another reason I love the WOM, like the whole acronym, is because like sometimes we get a business idea and we want to immediately talk about it. Like details aren't even finished. But listen, when you find out you're pregnant, you're not breaking open your stomach in 3 months. Like, look what's coming. No, you let that thing marinate and you let the baby, let the Lord do his thing. Yeah. So I feel like giving the resources, you're allowing people to build their business and present it the right way when
and
it's ready.
At the same time, when you're pregnant, you don't handle it by yourself. You go to professionals to help you take care of it the right way. So when you do birth it, you have a healthy baby.
Healthy.
Right? So we have to approach our businesses the same way. We can't, just because we have an idea about something, doesn't mean we don't need help to make sure it comes out and it happens the right way.
Right.
So tell us about your ideal client. I know we're talking about, we gave a lot of that, but talk about her. Who is she?
Right.
So my avatar, we call them our avatars, right?
Okay.
My avatar's name is Keisha.
Okay, Keisha.
We know that.
Keisha's about 38.
Come on, birthday. That's me.
Yeah, she's about 38. She is a mother. She's a full-time worker, so she has a full-time job. Mm-hmm. May or may not have a college degree. That's actually not important at all.
Absolutely not.
And I'm a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not important at all when it comes to business. And she is unafraid to take chances.
Ooh.
So she's the mom that, you know, will put money towards a vacation when she doesn't always have all her bills paid.
That's me too.
She's the mom that's gonna look for the new looks all the time. She's not afraid to do something a little different. And so that's the, we welcome all women. You know what I'm saying? We welcome all women, but I know that Keisha is the sister that we can help out.
Let me tell you, because I'm Keisha.
Come on, Keisha.
I'm Keisha.
I know.
It's
I know.
Keisha's,
Keisha's afraid.
Yes.
Keisha's unsure.
But she will never tell anybody she's
right. Because she's
outwardly
it.
Very confident.
Oh, she
on
handles
the inside,
it.
She is
done.
A hot mess on the inside.
Yeah, listen, Keisha unsure all over the place.
Yeah.
She's the house.
That's right.
Oh,
we all
do.
Right.
We absolutely all do.
Yes.
And I am guilty all day long.
Right.
Yeah. Especially those of us who are mothers, you have to be strong all the time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, and so you don't want to break in front of your kids.
Right.
You're struggling internally, you know, but you don't want to break in front of your kids. So Keisha represents that woman who just needs that extra support and chance. And she also needs to be in a room with sisters who look like her, who aren't afraid to tell her what she needs to hear.
Right. Like-minded.
Because a lot of those conversations we won't have in front of folks who don't look like us.
Shout out to the safe spaces,
Yeah. Gotta create that safe space.
Right.
And so that's something that, you know, I have to be able to say to you, don't put that on Facebook.
That's right.
Like, what are you doing?
Right.
That's right.
Your clients
and you
are looking
to
at you.
That.
Right.
And,
not,
and
yeah,
we're,
not
it's coming from a place of love.
That's right.
Coming from a place
absolutely
of love.
So.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
We got Keisha. So, look, the location. Listen, we on Legacy Internet Radio.
Yes.
as well. So let the listeners, tell the listeners about where they can come and find you at if you travel to meet them. Can it be digital? Is it face-to-face?
Right. So we do have an office on Lakeside.
Okay.
We actually have a co-op on Lakeside.
Richmond, Virginia, y'all.
Henrico County there. Okay. You know, they're very business-friendly. So.
Yes.
So our office, our co-op is in Lakeside. We basically have a group of 5 women who are all entrepreneurs who are all working together grow their individual businesses, and we have like a little workshop area and things like that. But we're mostly digital, because the idea is what we're planting in Richmond, we need to be able to pick up and plant in other cities.
Mm-hmm.
And so our website is wombiz.org. So wombiz.org. Okay. On Facebook, we're wombiz. On Instagram, which I'm horrible about.
Mm-hmm. It's okay. All right.
I'm just, you know. Listen. My son's tried. I don't know. It's all selfies. I have nothing else to take pictures of. I'm like, hey,
woman.
Right.
It's me.
Okay. Again. Yeah, okay. Yeah, what did I say? But it's mostly for we do a lot of our stuff on Facebook.
Okay.
So most of our stuff is on Facebook. So we have a free group because we want everybody to be able to access us as a Womb Network.
Okay.
And then our members, who are our paid members, they're part of the Womb Tribe.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so our tribe, they're able to participate in group coaching. We have accountability groups, collaborative groups.
Listen, it's levels. Yeah. I love it.
There's levels. There's levels to this thing. Absolutely.
I love it. I love it. I have one more question for you. Just for you as the woman who runs this whole situation, what do you do for your self-care when you leave the office, it's time you're at the house again, you know, we all sit on that edge of the bed trying to get our life together.
Right.
But what's the one thing you do to recharge, refresh, bring yourself back?
There's a lot of wine involved in that. Yes.
Shout out to
Thank God for Gwen Hurt and Shoe Crazy Wine.
Right, yes.
I'm also my mother's caregiver.
Okay.
So when I'm not working with Womb, my parents both came down from Connecticut a couple years ago, and so I'm usually kind of taking care of mom, hanging out with dad, taking care of mom.
Okay.
I'm helping my sons grow their businesses. They're both entrepreneurs as well. So it's they're twins. So, you know.
Okay. Come on.
Back to trouble.
Listen.
But they made it. They're 23. We survived childhood.
You know? Hallelujah. Yes.
We survived. I didn't kill them. So
shout out to those mothers with teenagers. I'm going to say that.
God bless them. God bless them. God bless all moms and teen boys.
I have one. Yes.
Mine's is, y'all ain't make me feel good about that. You know, son, he hit 10 next week. Oh, my daughter is preschool.
I'm going to tell you, that's a good age.
I teased my kids. I said, I didn't like y'all from 10 to 16.
It makes sense.
I loved you, but I really didn't like you till you
hit.
And then 16, they just turned into these amazing little angels.
Yeah,
but
that
in the middle
sense.
Years,
it was a hump, sis. But it's okay. It's okay.
All prayer and wine.
I want to thank you for being on the show with us tonight.
Thank you for having me back. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, absolutely. So this is not going to be your last time, right?
No, we have a networking event every single month where we feature our vendors. We have a trainer there. But the idea is what we call the one-to-one. So they're able to collaborate with each other. They sit down, they make their appointments.
Ooh.
Everybody has to walk out with at least 4 face-to-face appointments set with another business owner.
How do we set up for that? Is it the website?
So it's on our website.
Okay.
The January event sold out within a week.
Ooh.
So now we're yes, we're not mad at that. We're putting our February event, but it's every third Sunday.
Okay.
We're going to be partnering, this month we partnered with the Arts Community Center out on Hull Street Road, Cynthia Doyle Richardson and her husband Amiri, another black-owned venue, amazing venue, huge venue. And then we're going to be partnering with the Royal Manchester Event Center here out Southside. And so we'll be there Sunday. Yeah, every
Sunday.
So you have to
come back and keep us posted.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Well, it was an honor to have you
Thank
on tonight.
You.
Thank you for coming to join us.
Miss
Maya is always a mother. Yes, y'all. She gave us the talk of the streets.
Yes.
If you want more of that and see, check up on some of our other exclusive, then you might want to stay with us. Stay right here, wherever you at. Legacy Internet Radio, talkofthestreet.com, wherever you are. It's the talk of the streets, baby. We'll be right back.
La música de Harry Fraud.
All right, y'all. So we back with Talking the Street Entertainment, and I just put a whole pistachio in my mouth. Listen, y'all know I love you guys.
right?
Yeah.
They so good though. Shout out to pistachios. Shout out to pistachios. Shout out to let me see. Let me hold on. You know what? DJ Elon, Frito-Lay, right? They got pistachios?
Yes, ma'am. I've been telling you.
Okay, so shout out to Frito-Lay. We're just going to put it on there. Forget about it. Absolutely. I love me some pistachios, y'all. Pull them out of everywhere.
What's going on, everybody? I love when I say that. I need the whole bloopers. At the end of the year, I'm going to do a bunch of bloopers with my, what's going on, everybody?
What's going on?
Look, because all the guests be like,
what's she doing over there?
Yeah, she's all this shit. Yeah.